and happy holidays. It's really important to analyze the frequency components in your signal because they can often cause noise in your design, which can end up causing your device to malfunction. You can really easily do this using a Fast Fourier Transform, or FFT. If your design has excess noise, it can interrupt the functionality of components by exceeding certain tolerances or even causing voltage spikes that can damage your parts. This could be a problem that your customer ends up finding if you don't test correctly during your design phase. Analyzing the frequency content in your design is going to be a critical step in ensuring your device is going to work properly. You may not always associate frequency domain analysis with an oscilloscope because scopes are typically used to analyze the time domain. However, a scope's a really convenient tool for measuring and analyzing your frequency content as well. In this episode of Scopes University, you'll learn all about what an FFT is and how to use it on an oscilloscope so you can test your device as thoroughly as possible. You may remember learning about fast Fourier transforms, or FFTs, in your engineering classes. Very simply put, an FFT is basically just a math operation that splits up the signal you're seeing in the time domain, translates that information into the frequency domain, and displays it on the oscilloscope in a graph showing amplitude versus frequency. You can see in this image visually how the time domain and the frequency domain correlate, which makes this all a little easier to understand. You can see that the time domain signal is split out into each of the different sine waves that it's composed of, and each of those waves occur at a certain frequency and amplitude. There can be many circumstances where you find there are added frequency components in your design that shouldn't be there, or you find there's something like crosstalk that's causing issues with your components. All of these can be problems that cause your device to break or not work properly. These are problems that you can't often see in the time domain, so having the ability to view the frequency domain can reveal anomalies and glitches that you didn't even know were there. Or perhaps they are problems that you can see in the time domain, but you need to understand a little bit more about the frequency and power of that part of your signal. This will allow you to figure out what's causing that error or glitch so you can go back in your design and correct it. No matter what the case is for you, you can see how valuable this analysis is in understanding your device more. Using an FFT on an oscilloscope is really pretty easy, and I think it's a fundamental skill that's really important to learn. An FFT is just another math operation on the oscilloscope. So if you already have familiarity with setting up math operations, the process for setting up an FFT is very similar. Most of the InfiniVision oscilloscopes have an FFT button directly on the front panel. But for the ones that don't, you can just go into the math menu, press display to turn it on, and change the operator to FFT, and then set up the sources with the channels that you're trying to analyze. The signal we're looking at here is just a normal clock signal that appears to have some high frequency noise riding on it. So we're going to identify the source of this noise. The first thing I want to do is zoom out on the time base of the signal a little bit. Like I said, an FFT is just a math function, and the more data that math function has to work with, the more accurately it can calculate. Once you have the signal all set up with the FFT turned on, you can clearly see the spikes in frequency. You can auto-scale the FFT, or you can play around with the center and span settings to customize your view. The span setting is the FFT frequency width, and the center setting is the frequency in the middle of the span. So a 1 kHz span with a 10 kHz center frequency will show you the spectra from 9 kHz to 11 kHz. To analyze the frequency peaks, you can just press the Search front panel button and then change it to Frequency Peaks. And now you can scroll through the various frequency peaks on screen and verify that what you expect to see is actually there and debug any components that you were seeing that shouldn't be there. We can see the spike for the high frequency noise riding on the signal right here. And we can see it occurs at 19.5 megahertz. Now that we know what the frequency of the noise is, we can identify what it is that's causing it and figure out how to eliminate it. This could be happening for many reasons, but one of the main causes that we've been seeing more and more with modern technology as chips get smaller is crosstalk. If components or traces are placed too close together on a board, then the signals coming from them can end up interfering with each other, causing things like noise, like you saw in our signal we were working with here. So the solution could be something as simple as moving components around on your board. This is going to be different for every design, but having insight into the frequency helps a lot in debugging. FFT gives you a simple way to analyze the frequency without having to isolate certain parts of your signal or make any additional measurements. And you're able to do that all right on the screen of the scope while you're already doing all your other measurements. To learn more details about how to make advanced FFT measurements, make sure you check out the application note, How to Make FFT and Pulse RF Measurements. Thank you everyone for joining me. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel so that you can continue to see more videos from us, and check us out on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Happy holidays!